So, I'm gonna show you how to set up a new catalog in Fast Video Cataloger from scratch. So Fast Video Cataloger is a software that's gonna help you quickly find the videos you are looking for. So it's not hard to use, but I'm gonna give you a few pointers to get started in the right way, or according to me, the right way. So let's get started. So the first thing we're gonna talk a bit about is the catalog. So what is a catalog? It's basically a database file pointing to videos you have in your collection, and it contains all the metadata about the video files. So because of this, we probably want this catalog file in a location on your hard drive, on your SSD, that is quick to access, since normally when you use the program, when you search, it's only this catalog file that it's touched. It normally never touches video files unless you're actually watching a video or if you're adding new videos to your video catalog. So let's get started. We click new and then we click pick catalog file. So this allows us to select where we wanna store our catalog file. So this could be anywhere. So I'm just gonna save it here in my Fast Video Cataloger 8 folder. So let's give it a decent name. So at demo video, like that. Click save. See the path here, and then you click create to create a new catalog. So now we have an empty catalog. So there's nothing in it. We can easily see that if you go to help, click about, and then you see zero videos, no images, no actors. So the first thing we're gonna do now is add a few videos. But before we add it, I'm gonna change some settings in preferences, or at least show you where they are. So to go to preferences, we can press Ctrl P, which is a shortcut for open the preferences. But we could also go to the start menu and select preferences from here. So preferences, and the interesting one for video indexing is the video indexer tab. So let's go through the few options we have here. So the first option determines from the video the amount of seconds we're gonna wait from the start until we take the first screenshot. And then the second option is how long between each screenshots, and then the third one is a number that determines if it's a short video, so it doesn't really can use these numbers, then at least I want two video screenshots from the video, so I have something even for short clips. The next one determines how large the thumbnails should be. So when the video is indexed, thumbnails are captured and then they're scaled to this width. The aspect ratio of the video thumbnail is going to be kept, so we only need to set the width of them. The next few options are how we want to extract metadata from the videos. So the first option, if this is checked, we're going to look where the video file is, then see if there is an NFO file. So NFO is basically an XML file with metadata about the video. Some programs save these files. So if there's one there, then we can use this function to read them and automatically get that metadata about the video. The next option is to try to extract from metadata from the video files. So first here we have an option to just use the media info API to extract metadata. The second option is to use the Windows API to extract metadata. So there are some metadata that might look like they're in the video file, but that they're actually in the Windows shell. So for example, if you go into Windows, set a rating to video, that's normally like stored here. Same keywords. So the third option is to extract XMP metadata from the video. So some video software like Adobe's video editing software stores XML data inside of the video in something they call XMP format. So all of these are extracted when we find them as extended properties. So that's a term we use in Fast Video Cataloger for extracted metadata, unless it's like the standard ones like title or keywords or rating, then those end up just as if you set them from inside this program. But everything else that doesn't have a specific function in Fast Video Cataloger is stored as extended video property. The next one is a new option that was added in Fast Video Cataloger 8. This allow us to extract keywords from the video path. So this can be controlled from the auto keywording tab. So allow you to, like, if you store videos in folders, then you can actually get the folder names as keywords for the videos. Let's go back to the video indexing tab there, and then we continue. I should mention, I really like this function, you should give it a try. But it's good to first populate your catalog with a few videos, set up the structure, and then turn this function on. So by doing that, you can, if you have like a folder animal with animal videos, you tag a few of those, set this auto keywording options, and then whenever you add a new video to the animal folder, it's automatically gonna get the animal keyword. Next option is a rotate. This actually requires you to extract metadata, which we have checked here. So if you take videos with some video cameras, or rather some mobile phones, then they actually don't rotate the video even though the camera is rotated. Instead, they just store a metadata bit saying, oh, this was a rotated video, and then it's up to whatever player to rotate it back. So if this is checked, we're gonna check for that bit and then rotate the video automatically. Next option is just if we should refresh the search after each added video. I would normally have this on. It adds a few milliseconds or like a second for each index video. So if you have a really long queue with 10,000 videos, for example, then you might not want to have this while you add all the videos to your catalog. But otherwise, it's good to have. So you always have all the added videos in your search. Next options doesn't have to do with the actual normal initial indexing. It's more an option to add more thumbnails around a specific thumbnail. So this allow you to right click a thumbnail and then select burst capture. Then it's gonna capture for 1 second and take 10 frames. So it basically allow you, if something interesting is happening in a frame, then you could just, let's add more info here, so you can control how that actually works. What more? Yes, you should of course know that you can add any specific frame as well. The camera icon in the video player allow you to just take another frame where the video player is currently at. So the next two options are allowing you to mask or basically encrypt videos, and then an option to delete them. So we could, if you want to, as we add videos to the catalog, encrypt them as well. If you encrypt videos, I wouldn't start with that, first of all. If you encrypt them, they cannot be read outside of Fast Video Cataloger, so they are kind of protected. And the last option, again, I wouldn't recommend trying this as start, is allow the program to use the codecs for videos that are installed on your computer instead of the built-in codecs. So in 99% of the cases, you probably want to use the built-in codecs, because they're gonna be able to index way more video formats than what typically is installed on a computer. But if you really know what you're doing, and if you have specific codecs installed, or if a video fails for some reason to index, this might be an option to check. So if it's checked, we're gonna just use the Windows system to determine what codecs are there, their priority between them, and so on. So, and then you can see a lost field here is an output debug folder. It's just for writing extra debug information. Don't fill that in at all. Okay, so I actually never changed any of the options for the video, just left it as default, but now you should have a better idea. So and this is options that are saved between programs runs. So what you typically, or people typically change after a while with the program, is like how often they want frames captured and how long the thumbnails will be, and also if they want XML, XMP or metadata extracted. So let's continue. So we are now, we set our preferences, so we are now ready to add videos to the catalog. So we go to the add video window. So might be interesting to know, like, why do we have these windows here? So if you go to the view menu here, you can control which windows are visible in the program. So there are a ton of windows functionality available in the program, but for this first tutorial we're just gonna look at the add video. We add some videos to your catalog, and then we're gonna dig deeper into all this in the next video. So here it's pretty work from the top to the bottom. So first we're gonna select the videos we want to add to the catalog that we want to index. So you can do that either by picking file by file or picking a complete folder of videos. Some options here, if we click a folder, we can select if you want to recurse from that folder and add all subfolders. So for example, if you want to add all videos on your D drive, you just select D and then include subfolders, and it's gonna scan all the videos and add them. The next option is skip added. This basically ignores any video that's already in your catalog. So even if you changed preferences, it's not gonna be added again. And then the last option here is just showing that we currently not auto-indexing from a folder. So you can set up the program to look in a folder if there is an added file in there, and then automatically index that. But we haven't enabled that. We can have a look at that later in another tutorial. So I'm gonna add a folder with videos. I have prepared a folder here. Just select that, and then it's gonna get scanned. And then let's have a look at what we see here. So we see none of these videos are catalog. They're not in our catalog now, which makes sense since we have an empty catalog. Now we have a title of them. We have the path to the videos. We have the file modify date. How large are they? And then are they encrypted, masked already? And then it's an auto keyword folder. Since we haven't enabled that function in the preferences, we don't get any auto keywords here. Next step is to just set how thumbs should be generated. We choose to just use the settings and preferences for now. Next step, if you want to set any shared properties for all the videos that are going to be added to the catalog, we can do that. We can also just add all the shared properties later by just marking all the videos and just adding the properties. And then finally, there is a start button to get started with indexing. So let's click that and get started. So what's gonna happen now is the program is gonna go through all the videos. It's gonna scan for thumbnails. It's gonna scan for XML data, metadata, and all those options we had. And then they're gonna add it to the catalog. And it's gonna do this indexing in a separate process. So even if like the video codec crashes or there is a problem with it or something, then that's just gonna fail the video. We're still gonna continue with the next video in the queue, and then you can try to troubleshoot that problem later, but at least the program won't fail. And also, after each video is indexed, the list of videos left to index is also saved. So if your computer for some reason crashes or is rebooted or something, or you just happen to turn it off, then the next time you return, it's gonna continue where it left off. So this is super useful if you have, which is pretty typical, if you have a really long list of videos, like the first time you're using the program. So, as this program is adding videos, we can see here in the video catalog window that we're getting more and more videos added. And you see here, you get them one way, and as we see them get added to the catalog, we can also go into the about box, and you see now we have 23 videos, we have 8 minutes of video, 920 megabytes, and so on. And that is basically how you go about and create a new catalog, add videos to it, and we are finally getting started with the Fast Video Cataloger. Stay tuned for the next video.